Let's continue the money talk today. Pay rate negotiation for UX designers. Thanks Annie again for the topic recommendation. In this video, I'll walk you through some tips and tricks of negotiating for higher pay for any offer that you might get. Personally, I've successfully got higher pay after a few back and forth with the company, and I'm going to share those stories with you. Now let's get started and roll the intro. Good morning everyone, my name is Justine, I'm a designer working in Silicon Valley. My negotiation experience is more or less for new grads, meaning it's your first job out of school. I'm going to share you with my stories and some general principles behind it which should apply for you down the road as well. And specifically, here's what I have for you today. I'm going to go over three stories on negotiation: Fitbit, DoorDash, and my current company. I'll walk you through the details and what exactly I did within those. This should be fairly straightforward, so now without further ado, let's dive right into it. Offer number one, Fitbit. If you remember from my last video, the Fitbit offer that I got was a base pay of 110K as a product designer. The 110K base pay is actually after negotiation, so let's rewind back to August 14, 2019 and start from there. So this is the first email that they informed me that they will extend an offer. So it says something like, based on where you level off against the existing team, the max we could go would be around 105 base with 5% bonus. And of course, it's time for negotiation. So this is how I responded. 105 base comp seems a little low in my opinion. I check against the market and compare with my other offer. So I was looking at 130K plus or minus. So I gave them a range there. I don't think that's a crazy number. With just that nudging, I was able to get my base comp from 105K to 110K. It's not exactly 130K, but hey, my base pay did go up, right? Even though in the original email it says the max we can go with. And you know, the max is always relative. So here are the two conclusions, two tips, two findings I got from this experience. Tip number one, don't give them a number, let them give you the number first. If you ever ask, you can just say, oh, I don't have time to look into it yet. I'm busy interviewing with other companies. I don't have too much of an expectation at this point. Just try to ballpark and we will start from there. It's as easy as that. Also, it's the recruiter's job to get you hired with the lowest compensation that they can get you. To prevent getting lowballed, let them speak first. Tip number two, should hire, land in the middle. As a new grad, I honestly didn't know what the base pay, what the compensation was back then. My personal guess was 120K is pretty good, decent, it's okay. So I shot for 130K, and between 105 and 130, maybe they will land somewhere in between 120. And you know, that did give me a boost. It's just instead of 120, it's 110, not to the same extent, but that strategy kind of worked generally. So now let's get to offer number two, DoorDash. After I got my master's degree at ArtCenter in 2019, I got an offer from DoorDash and actually another startup. Let's call it Startup K. And you know, I did the same thing. I didn't give them a number to begin with, so I let them speak first. And magically, they were able to benchmark enough companies and offers, I guess. They gave me the same base pay. And in this particular scenario, I'm going to leave equity out of the consideration because DoorDash gave me stocks while Company K gave me options, which were harder to evaluate at that point because they're still a startup. So let's say they're close enough and skip this part. Well, since they have the same pay, basically, from a compensation standpoint, purely, there's no incentive to go with one or the other. Not that compensation is the only thing that you should think about. So I look at them closely. There are two different roles, actually. DoorDash is a product design role. Company K is a prototype role. Two different opportunities, two different experiences to have. Not exactly apple to apple, they're both great. It's not gonna go wrong with either one. Then, after re-evaluating my priorities, it seems like it's better for me, personally, so it's case by case, to take a product designer role just because I don't have extensive knowledge in that area. Which means I'm slightly leaning towards DoorDash, but at the same time, because they have the same pay, same compensation, relatively, there's no real incentive to tip either way. So here's what I did. I spoke with both company again and I asked a few questions. So the first thing I did was the should hire, land in the middle, but unfortunately neither of them would like to budge. They would just stay with the same base pay that they offered me initially. And then the next thing that I asked was a sign-on bonus. As you know, it's fairly common in the Bay Area. It's just with a one-year cliff. Company K wouldn't do sign-on bonus, but magically, DoorDash is willing to offer a 10K sign-on bonus. And in this case, it totally breaks the tie. I'm slightly leaning towards DoorDash for the product designer experience or the knowledge of things I will be learning. And also, they gave me a 10K sign-on bonus. So here we go, DoorDash. And from this negotiation, I also get two different findings, conclusion, and tips for you. Tip number one, it will be easier to negotiate when you have other competing offers. It makes a whole lot of sense because it gives you additional leverage. So the action item I will have or recommend will be interview with multiple places at once. You're preparing your portfolio, your presentation, your on-site, get your mind into the right space anyways. So why not just do that, shoot for multiple companies, get multiple offers, let them compete with each other, get as much leverage as you have in the negotiation phase. Tip number two, get a verbal offer first, but ask for the offer letter later, as late as you could. This is something that you might need to know. Once you have the offer letter, once the recruiter sends you the offer letter, you have to sign it within a time frame, which tends to be a really short window, 2 days, 3 days, a week. But once you already have a verbal offer, you can use that to tell the other company or other companies that you're interviewing with to let them speed up the process to get you another verbal offer. And then once you finish all your interviews, you have all the verbal offers in hand, then you have a lot more options. You have a lot more leverage. In my personal example, if I get my offer letter from DoorDash a lot earlier than my offer from Company K, I might not be able to compete and then get my final 10K sign-on bonus. Offer number three, my current company. I got an offer from my current company after I joined DoorDash, meaning I was already working as a full-time designer in Silicon Valley. The base pay for my current company came out also magically the same as DoorDash. However, they do not have a sign-on bonus. In the beginning, I didn't want to review any of my DoorDash compensation to my current company, hoping they might get me a higher compensation, a higher base pay. Well, it didn't happen, and it didn't give me a sign-on bonus either, which means from a compensation standpoint, it's actually a worse offer. So I have to approach it differently. One rule about sign-on bonus is that it tends to have a one-year cliff, meaning if you leave at any point within the first year of your start date, you have to give that sign-on bonus back to the company. If I were to join a new company, that means I have to give that 10K sign-on bonus back to DoorDash because I'm leaving within 1 year. And therefore, that's what I said to the recruiter. Incredibly thankful for the opportunity. This is great. At the same time, I'm also incredibly happy working at DoorDash, meaning I don't have to leave. And I also told them, if I'm leaving DoorDash right now, I have to give all the sign-on bonus back to DoorDash because of the 1 year cliff. Can you guys at least cover that? And then after a few days, they got back to me and magically something interesting happened. Since they don't use to give sign-on bonuses, so they can only make that many exceptions. They ended up giving me 5K on the top of my base pay and 5K on a sign-on bonus, which is actually a better deal for me considering that this company have the end of year bonus, which is based on the base pay. So the higher the base pay, the higher the bonus. And here we are, another success in negotiation. While this is very exciting, the money, the compensation is not the main reason I joined the company. So the tip here, again, it's easier to negotiate for additional pay, for higher pay, if you have competing offers. In my scenario, the competing offer is the DoorDash offer itself, the current job that I had back then. Because think about it, your current job is the best competing offer. It's the living offer that you have all the time with you as your leverage to negotiate for higher salary, higher compensation, and so on. So what do you guys think? Do you have a better sense of what negotiation might look like for UX designers? Generally speaking, as a general tip, new grads tend to have less room, not a lot of room for negotiation. Because in that scenario, you need them more than they need you. So be thankful, be grateful. They are the one giving you a big break. They are taking a chance on you. Don't give them an impression that you are money-grabbing monster designer that care about money more than design when you first start your career. If you have other thoughts and comments, feel free to let me know in the comment section down below. Here are some related topics that I plan to talk about in future videos. If you have preferences of which one you want me to talk about first, let me know. If you think of something that's not here, feel free to let me know as well.
Well, that's it for today. Thank you guys for watching. If you find this video useful or insightful, please destroy the like button for YouTube algorithm. This is still a small channel, so every like counts, and I would greatly, greatly appreciate it.
If you want to see more UX career tips or design videos like this, consider smash the subscribe button as well. Doing so will tremendously help the channel and motivate me to produce more high quality content down the road. Have fun following your passion and keep designing a better future. See you on the next video. Tschüss!